It's rare. We're running out of this. This is New York. When you come in here, this is New York. And it's giving me that feeling of feeling like a kid again, man, at the candy store. I just wanted everything.
Yes, sir, yes, sir. I'm growing up in Iran. One day I was on the street, somebody said, why you don't join Navy? I said, what is Navy? He says, come on, I'll show you what's Navy. We went to Saudi Arabia, Pakistan, India, Spain. Then we came to Virginia. And if you look from sea to Virginia, it's like an ocean of trees, like a heaven. And I say, man, this is the place I like to live. So we were anchored about a half a mile away in the water. Everybody was sleeping like 2 or 3 in the morning, and I sneak out, jump, swim to the shore. I went straight to the train station. I didn't know where the train is going. I don't care. It was going to Miami. So I'm walking around the street. There's a window that says Jobs, and I go right in. And when we went to eat lunch, I told my friends that I am homeless. I have no place to sleep. So why homeless? Where I stay is a furnished room is $6 a week. Come on. So I was happy, sunshine, money is good, $110 every 2 weeks. My rent was $6, good country. My friend had a pickup truck, says, let's go Miami Beach. We're enjoying the weather, nice. And all of a sudden, this guy came, FBI, against the wall. Everybody showed me ID. Everybody had ID, except me, no ID. They took me to the police station, fingerprinted me, and they put me in a little hole. And I stayed there a couple hours. Man, look, if they deport me, I'm going to get shot. So somebody came, opened the door, said, hey, you got $20? I say, I have $20, sure. Here's $20. And they said, but you have to come back next month to the court. So explain why you don't have ID. So, okay. I didn't go home. I went on a Greyhound bus to New York. I had an apartment on 13th Street, between A and B. And I was paying $32 a month rent. Now, this was a bad time in the area. Nobody worked. Everybody buying and selling drugs. I had two jobs, cleaning job from 6 in the morning to 12. At 12 o'clock, 1 hour break. Then I was busboy until midnight. And I saved every penny. It took 10 years to save $33,000. And I want to buy a restaurant. My friend told me that you don't need a restaurant. You need a candy store.
We've been coming here forever for the egg creams of all my cousins, all my people. When the family visits, this is where we come.
Old fashioned.
It is.
It's the way it was when our parents used to tell us about it, and it's still the same. It just never changed.
It's a New York thing.
It would be a very different place without Riz.
All right. I'm so happy to be in America. You know? I have so much hard time. I appreciate every minute of it. The weather was bad. I had a bad health. They were ripping me up like $200-$400 a day. Came to the point that I had no money to pay the lights. I had no money to pay the rent. I called the landlord that can I pay the rent in the summer? I don't have money. He said, no. They send the eviction notice. I was like 2 weeks late. So I called the homeless guy outside. I said, listen, here's the key. I am going. He said, where are you going? I said, I'm not going to tell anybody. I'm just going to disappear. I started a new life somewhere else. I said, no, Ray, stay, Ray, stay. He starts screaming, Ray, stay! And everybody, what's going on? He said, he wants to run away. So everybody said, no, 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 Ray, stay. Everybody threw him the $5 bill, $10 bill, $1 bill. The word go around, the New York Times guy come, and the Fox News come. Then they had a concert in a theater for a new city. So I paid the rent, and I paid the lights, and I stayed. I really don't want to retire because I will miss the people, you know. I want to be with the people. If you do good, you get good. And I did my best. And I got it back. My neighbors, they love me. And thank you very much. Bye.